Good morning, everybody, and welcome back. And for all you new people out there, don't forget to subscribe and hit the little notification bell. I do appreciate it. Today, we're going to talk about what happens when you put regular gas in a two-cycle engine. Two-cycle engines are intended to have a 40 or maybe a 50-to-1 oil-gas mixture in it. And the mixture, the oil that you put in with the gas, is intended to lubricate the cylinder. So what happens to an engine when it doesn't get that lubrication? I have a piece of equipment here where the gentleman ran out of gas while doing his yard, and he figured, well, I usually use 40-to-1, and so one tank won't hurt anything. So he went ahead and put a tank of regular gas in, figuring that he still had a tiny little bit of fuel left in the bottom, and that might be enough to lubricate it. And, well, let's see what happened to the engine after one tank of gas. Okay, I've got a chainsaw here that's been, it's about 10 years old, and it's had a pretty good life. It's been taken care of pretty well, and so I want to use it as our base. We're going to look at what a 10-year-old engine looks like that has gotten the 40-to-1 mix its entire life. So we're going to take it apart really quick here. Okay, that didn't take long. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take your view down to this camera here. Give me one second. I'm setting your view up on this camera here. So let's have a look at what that engine looks like on the inside after all that time. 10 years of running. If you look, the cylinder looks pretty shiny. You can see a little bit of cross-thatching still on it and perhaps a tiny little mark here and there. But other than that, it's a pretty good looking engine. There's the exhaust side, which is the hottest, and you can see just the vaguest hints of lines. So this engine's in pretty good shape. Now you notice the piston looks pretty dark, and that's normal. That's carbon buildup because this is on a chainsaw, and they just run rich. So you're gonna see the darkness on the piston, and obviously this machine is in really good shape. So let's put her back together real quick, and we'll go. Okay, that didn't take long. So let's put her off to the side. And let's have a look at this little blower motor. This came off of a Ryobi blower that had been run with no oil in it. They ran it straight gas, but they only did it one time. So here's what happened. Let's go back down to the camera. And let's have a look inside. See, now if we look at this engine, you can see the piston's nice and clean. It's nice and clean because there was no oil at all. Let's see if we can get a look at the cylinder. Now, if you look at the cylinder wall, see that little black ring around the top here? That is just heat. That was just from it running too hot from not having oil in it. And these streaks down the side, that was the piston ring coming apart inside the engine. Now, this only ran one time with regular gas in it. See if we can bring the piston up. There you go. There's the piston all the way down. That's the exhaust port right there. And there's the intake port. The intake port usually looks cleaner than the exhaust port. That's where you usually will have your problems. So let's try to look at the side of the piston itself. Let's bring her up. And if we look at the actual piston, let's bring the brightness down just a touch. You can see the gouging in the side. Let's see if we can find the piston rings in this one. There you go. Now we can take a look at the rings, and you can see the rings are just completely destroyed. Oh, that's a really good shot there. See how the rings have got all the little marks and everything on them? That's from running with no lubrication. Now this only ran with one tank and it did that much damage. Okay, I hope this has been helpful. We saw a motor that had been run for 10 years and he religiously put 40-to-1 mix in it. And after 10 years of hard running, that motor still looks fantastic. It's still ready to go probably another 10 years. And then we saw another motor that was only a couple of years old that he ran one tank of regular gas in it. He was halfway through the job, he ran out, and he said, okay, I can probably get away with it since I've always put 40-to-1 mix in it. It's probably okay to run one tank. And it didn't even finish the job. And what would no longer start, he brought it to me. So I hope this is a good lesson for anybody who ever considers putting regular gas in a two-cycle engine. I appreciate y'all watching, and we'll see you next time.